The official death toll from the series of quakes that rocked the southern Philippines now stands at 23. 7 deaths were recorded from the October 16 quake, while 16 more were registered following this week's back-to-back tremors. Majority of those deaths were caused by falling debris. This is why the country's disaster agency is calling on all residents to have their homes properly assessed before returning. The agency warns tremors are expected to continue to rock the region.
We're advising them to stay in the open spaces, in the evacuation centers, and don't insist on going back, because usually what's happening is people who go back are the ones who get trapped.
President Rodrigo Duterte has ordered local government units in quake-hit areas to inspect buildings before these are occupied again.
For those who are staying in buildings, structures that are not fit for human habitation, tignan nilang mabuti. Because lalo na yung mga may semento.
The Philippine Institute of Volcanology and Seismology has recorded almost 400 aftershocks since Thursday's quake. The agency has installed seismic instruments on Mount Apo.
Walang ikakabahala yung taong are also concerned about, you know, if there will be another, you know, if the events have affected Mount Apo, which is considered as potentially active volcano.
Experts have yet to provide a definite explanation on the series of quakes in Mindanao.
There's another theory in earthquake studies that says that when one fault moves, it can trigger the movement of a nearby fault. And if there's another nearby fault, the second fault that was generated would trigger the third, and so on and so forth. Mm-hmm. So this is another, as I said, alternate interpretation for now. But we are still looking at really more arguments or more pieces of evidence to really pinpoint which faults are causing which earthquakes.
Based on the latest figures of the Social Welfare Department, over 6,000 families are affected by the quakes. That's over 30,000 people in 72 villages. Some of them are staying in evacuation centers. 2,000 houses were damaged.
What we are sending right now are tents, laminated sacks, hygiene kits, plastic bottles for their as their water containers. Mm-hmm. We are also sending food packs. We are also providing psychosocial interventions because we need to recognize that not all are actually equipped with mental instrumentalities to cope up with this trauma that they are experiencing.
The NDRRMC says it can still provide aid for affected residents even without donations from other countries.
Ang nangyayari po ngayon is the Regional Disaster Council and the National Council are only on standby mode to provide assistance. Mm-hmm. Hindi po umaabot sa point na parang wala na silang magawa dun sa ground at magte-take over si national or si regional in the management of the emergency.
Jasmine Romero, ABS-CBN News.